to present you my personal top 5 heavy premium tanks that we can buy from World of Tanks, from Wargaming. And before you say like Defender is like number one, why you're even making this top, it's obvious. It's not quite obvious, and I have my personal opinions that I wanna state and perhaps change your mind. And let's start from number 5. That's the new Polish tank, the 50 TP prototype. It's a decent tank, it has good penetration, good alpha damage, good average damage per minute, decent aim time, good aiming time, which your beloved Defender doesn't has, and dispersion is great, you can pretty much snipe on this tank. Armor looks good on a bit numbers, but this is actually where this tank falls down. It has one big spot over here. No matter how you turn it, these plates will be penetratable easily, these ones. So that 170 is not really reflecting here. Also, this 170 reflects only on this top portion. The lower skid plate is very easy to penetrate, unlike the Defender's one. This is why this tank is so low. It's number 5. It's still a decent tank, but it is lower than Defender for this reason. Otherwise, if it was like Defender with no weak spots like this, it would have been better than Defender because its technical characteristics are better. The movement speed is about the same, view range is better than of that of Defender. Aim time and DPM is way better. Another problem I see with this tank is that those trousers, they're like bananas, very easy to overturn, and people start shooting you, penetrating you here. So yeah, it is one of those tanks that it is decent to play, but it's not number one, unfortunately. Let's move to number 4. Number 4 is Liberty, a good old tank. Everything is pretty much good about it. Mobility, penetration, dispersion, you can snipe in this tank easily. DPM is decent, what can you say, aiming time is decent. Only two problems is the Capola weak spot, and another one, you cannot overturn this tank because those chicks will be easily penetrated. Other than that, it doesn't have any real major downfall other than the view range, which is weaker. Front, of course, it's unpenetratable. Only like tire tents will penetrate your front, so you don't need to turn it around. This one is almost impossible to penetrate. Great tank overall, worth your purchase. Let's move to tire 3. Tire 3 is Lua. Another great tank. Good penetration, good dispersion. You can snipe in this tank. Good aiming time. Great overall armor. It has no weak spots on top. Of course, we are not talking about sides or back. Those are weak spots on every tank. The only weak spot this tank has and that cannot bounce is the lower skid plate. So you will need to make sure that you either start side scrape properly or hold down. Mobility is slower. He is slower, but he still can do his job well. DPM is a little bit on the bad side, but the reason it got so high up is because of its armor, penetration, and really, overall value. Because with heavy tanks, it is very important to have that armor that you can rely on to tank the damage, to get those bounces, and actually make sure that you do damage your enemies. You need the time to aim down, which you do not have in the Polish tank, for example. You really need to focus on, your position. Here it's very easy, and only drawback is the DPM, in my opinion. Well, the mobility a little bit, but still, it's not that bad. Going to number 2. Number 2 is your beloved Defender. Yes, it is number 2, it's not number 1, and I will explain you why later. Great tank, everyone knows it's almost OP. But its technical characteristics are falling down. Dispersion is bad, you will not be able to snipe, it's a close range tank. Aim time is long, stabilization is bad. Penetration is good, alpha damage is good, DPM is good. Armor is great. Even though numbers looks a little bit lower than other tanks that we went through, because they are sloped so sharply, it is very hard to penetrate. And if you turn him like this, approximately, it's impossible to penetrate him frontally. Of course, gold will be able to penetrate your lower skid plate, but you know, people have to switch on gold. It's not like with Polar's Defender. Yeah, we will call him Polar's Defender, who really can take any damage over here and to his small spot over there, that thing. So yeah, it is a great tank, but I don't believe it was updated, and its aim time, view range, dispersion, they should be a little bit adjusted with time, just to, you know. Only thing that saves this tank right now is its armor. But yes, it is good that it's on number 2. Once again, like with Luva, its armor is great, it's easier to actually make the damage count. And finally, number 1. Number 1 is this guy, Chrysler GF. Great tank in every aspect. Great armor, great mobility, it's an agile tank. Great dispersion, you can snipe. Best DPM out of all the tanks we just went through. Penetration is a little bit of a drawback, but let me explain that this DPM, this penetration, is more than enough to penetrate all tanks that you want to penetrate. And those tanks like IS-7 lower skid plate or mouse, you will need to sling gold anyways. You will have to do it on Defender and every other tank we went through. But other than those tanks that you have to hands down still sling gold, other tanks you will be able to penetrate with this quite easily, with absolutely no issues. Maybe versus a 430U you will need to sling gold as well, but you know, Defender will need to do it as well, so it's not like it's going to be a big deal. In every other regard, it's the best tank. Armor wise, once again, you can side scrape. It's unpenetratable over here. People have to really try to hit your cupola. Almost no one does it properly. The lower plate, it have to be shoot tire 8s for the most part, have to shoot gold. Only tire 8s with 230 penetration can penetrate this one, and only get it gets orange bar to actually penetrate it. So only half the time bullets go through, so you can even angle it a little bit and make it even harder for them. Of course, tire stance will be able to penetrate you just like Defender and everyone else we just discussed. View range is great. It has like great armor, great mobility. What else? The medium tanks, they won't be able to make circles around you. You turn extremely fast. You have good ground resistances and high specific power. Like technically, from technical characteristics, it's the best tank out of those we just looked through. Armor wise, same. Only drawback is this average penetration and gun depression, but you still can leave it with -6, you know. Well, this was it for my top 5. Thank you for watching the video. Give me a thumbs up. Enjoy.